My name is William Clemmons, graduate student here at Miskatonic University. Thank you for responding to my advertisement in the Arkham Advertiser. Arkham has lots of interesting people to see and places to go. How could I forget? Old Arkham Sanitarium. I would love to take over the sanitarium. This all goes towards helping us to isolate the segment of the population that may experience this feeling. A.S.M.R. Arkham Sanitarium mental response. My wife has left her theater mask once again at my office. Hello, darling. She's expecting. Any trouble sleeping? Okay. I'm just going to form some calm and slow hand movements. Of course, you can see the spinal cord, the vertebrae. Breathe in deep. And exhale. Cutting mat of mine, one of my favorite things. I use it quite often. They use tinfoil as a means of protecting themselves. Such a wonderful invention. Corrugated cardboard. It is very difficult to resist the temptation or urge to pop each individual bubble. That reminds me, I just thought about my camera. I'm gonna need to take that to the repairman. These are actually my brother's medical books. Unfortunately, he was a part of a tragic accident. His face has since become disfigured. Can you tell me how that made you feel? Okay. How are you? It's nice to meet you. My name is William Clemmons. I am a graduate student here at Miskatonic University. Oh, I will be graduating this year with a master's in psychology with an interest in geology, the occult, and a few other areas of interest. Well, thank you very much for responding to my advertisement in the local paper, the Arkham Advertiser. Are you a native resident of Arkham? No, just visiting? Okay, great. Have you been here long? Had a chance to go sightseeing? Not really? Okay, well, Arkham has quite its own character and lots of interesting people to see and places to go. Right down the street is the Miskatonic Museum, where you will find a wide variety of interesting items and artifacts from all across the globe, and some even say from places that don't even seem they were, well, of the earth. And then, let's see, well, there is up north, towards the edge of town, is the Miskatonic River. It's quite a lovely place, some nice scenic views. You can take a walk along the river as well, you know, grab a bite to eat, some benches and lots of trees. It's really nice in the spring and in the fall. Let's see where else. Oh, if you do happen to go out exploring, try to avoid the western hills of Arkham. Believe it or not, there was a recent meteor crash, And apparently the meteor and whatever is contained, I mean, they're still, it's cordoned off and whatnot. They are still examining it, but it has poisoned the land as well as the vegetation. So, I mean, you could go take a look, but I would try to avoid it altogether. As far as some interesting sites, there is just southeast of the Miskatonic campus, there is the old witch house. Reportedly, it's cursed and was cursed by an old witch by the name of Keziah Mason, if I'm not mistaken. I wasn't born and raised in Arkham, but I took up residence here in order to seek to obtain my degree from, you know, one of the finest educational institutions here in the United States. Let's see. How could I forget? There is Old Arkham Sanitarium, which provides some of the finest health care to those residents, or actually to anyone from across the United States who are suffering from any serious mental health issues. Well, not necessarily serious. I mean, if you have depression, anxiety, you can see one of the many specialists there, and you can even they even provide long-term residence. The only problem is that the sanitarium is quite old. It's becoming run down and dilapidated, unfortunately. And there have even been talks about them wanting to shut it down, which of course would be terrible. It would displace all of the residents. So I have been thinking, and some of us here as well, some of the other members of the faculty, some of the professors and doctors have been considering, it would be quite a financial investment to do this, but renovating the sanitarium, bringing it up to date, so to speak, with modern technology. But not really sure if that's going to happen. There's, you know, even talks of the lead director stepping down. So it's a shame what's become of the place, but if it were up to me, and, you know, if I were to ever become, you know, in such a standing member of society where I had the financial means, I would love to take over the sanitarium and, you know, revitalize it in order to provide some of the best care for so many people, you know, in need, and so many troubled minds. That's really it. I mean, there's so many, the buildings, the character, you know, the gambrel rooftops. One place that you might want to avoid, besides the witch house, is a town up north, further up north in Massachusetts here, outside of Arkham. It's the old port town of Innsmouth. Residents there don't really take too kindly to outsiders. Now, there's an old rickety bus that you can catch from Arkham that will take you up there. So if you have any friends or acquaintances, it's probably a good idea not to go alone. But, you know, if you're curious, you know, maybe during the daytime might be best. Okay, so I know the advertisement did not contain a lot of information about why you're here and this test that you have been so kind and gracious to volunteer, and of course which we will pay you for at the end of the session. I could only squeeze so many sentences into that little advertisement box, but basically myself and some of my colleagues and some of the other members of the faculty. I'm not sure if you're familiar with a Professor Dyer. Okay. And there's also a gentleman by the name of Herbert West and another person by the name of Miss Peasley. But in any case, as part of an internship that I did over at Arkham Sanitarium, I began to hear some reports of some of the patients stating that they, when receiving their treatments or getting their haircut, you know, some of the residents have some physical and mental disabilities and they're unable to take care of themselves. But some of them, you know, reported that when receiving the, you know, their treatments or the attention of the physician or nurse, they would feel this crawling sensation, this tingling sensation. Yeah, are you familiar with this? Okay, and you know, we were quite intrigued. You know, so we started some, you know, minor investigations just to determine what this tingling sensation is, and apparently in response to certain stimuli, the human body or the brain produces a chemical that creates a very pleasing sensation. We're not quite sure at this time why this occurs, although we can somewhat hypothesize that is some kind of evolutionary trait that has been passed down throughout the, you know, ages, generations. So as part of this test, which is not invasive at all, and which we'll get to in just a moment, some questions I would like to ask you, I'm just going to generate some sounds that some people have reported to be very calming and pleasing or pleasant to hear, and also some I'm just going to perform some calm and slow hand movements like so, just to see if you respond visually to this stimulus. And I'll be taking some notes throughout, and of course, as a token of our thanks and for your participation in this test, you know, we will provide you with a small financial benefit. Okay, so let me just get started here. Just a few questions, nothing too personal or too prying, but may I have your full name, please? Okay. Spell the last name again, please. Ah, okay. Thank you. Your birth year. Please, I don't need the month or the date. Okay, thank you. It's just a more professional way of asking how old you are. May I also have your city or state or locale and country of residence? Mm-hmm. Do you or anyone in your family have a history of any medical issues such as high blood pressure, diabetes, etc.? Okay. Okay. that you're aware of, maybe. All right. Okay. Are you currently taking any prescribed medications? Are you a current smoker or drinker, or have you done so in the past? Okay. No, it's just to, you know, as we conduct these tests, it's just to gather some information in order to determine if there's any possible correlation between, you know, what might impede someone from feeling this sensation, or, you know, there's any relationship between what someone, you know, puts in their body or their current state of mind and things like that. And don't worry, this information is completely confidential. Okay, do you ever feel anxious or stressed? No, no matter what the situation might be. Okay. Do you ever find it difficult to overcome said anxiety or stress? Mm-hmm, okay. Any trouble sleeping? Okay. Do you have you ever experienced sleepwalking or night terrors, or know anyone, a partner or in your family that has caught you sleepwalking or having night terrors? Okay. I used to have both myself, well, not any extreme cases of night terrors. I have sleptwalked, and I have moved about, not too violently in bed in terms of night terrors, but I was caught a couple times by my fiance, at the time my wife now, I'm moving about in bed, my elbows and such. Do you experience vivid dreams? Okay. Would you consider yourself an introvert? Where you have not necessarily suppress, but you keep a lot of your feelings and your thoughts inside. Maybe you have a very rich inner world, or you a social butterfly, an extrovert, and you just love to talk to anyone. Okay. Again, this is really just to determine any correlation between this experience that people are feeling, this tingling sensation, and if it has anything to do with personality, genetics, just to try to narrow down our scope, to see if it's a certain type of person that only experiences this tingling sensation. Okay. Is there anything else you'd like to make me aware of? Oh, okay, that's fine. I'll just put not at this time. Okay. And if you could just sign your name right here at the bottom. Thank you. Well, I want to thank you very much for your patience so far. I promise this won't take too much more of your time, and I appreciate your cooperation as well. This all goes, as I said, towards helping us to try and isolate the segment of the population that may, you know, experience this feeling, this sensation, which we actually don't quite have a term for yet, although I'm thinking of A.S.M.R., because it was originally somewhat discovered during some tests at Arkham Sanitarium. I'm thinking Arkham Sanitarium, I don't know, mental response, something like that. Okay, we're going to... Well, we're about to move into the test, but it appears that my wife has left her theater mask once again at my office. She's also in medical school to become a nurse. And I'm hoping that once we both graduate, she'll be able to assist me. If you don't mind, I just want to give her a quick call. I believe she might have her show tonight, performance. I do apologize. This is quite unprofessional, but I do appreciate your patience and your understanding. Hello, darling. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, everything's fine. You left your theater mask here. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I have it sitting right here at my desk. Mm-hmm. Oh. Oh, okay. Oh, the show's tomorrow night. I see. Okay. Well, then I'll just bring it home. No, I promise. Mm-hmm. I'm in the middle of another test. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You did? It was kicking? She's expecting. I wish I was there. I promise I won't be too late tonight. Mr. West? Really? I'm sorry. Just a moment more, please. What was he inquiring about? An experiment? Interesting. Do you know if he'll be calling again? He would like me to see him tomorrow in the morning? Okay. I can do that. All right, my darling. I promise to see you soon. Okay. Goodbye. Well. Fortunately, she doesn't need her mask, so I'm just going to set that here so that I can take it with me on my way home. She is training to be a nurse, studying to be a nurse, but she has such a passion for theater. She's in this show. She's always in this recurring show where she wears this mask. She has a red wig. It's really a fabulous. She plays this this colorful character. I don't know. I don't want to spend any more time talking about it. But in any case, you seem to be curious about this. Yeah, this is quite interesting. If you're not familiar, this is basically gives you a lateral view of the human skull and the brain. You can see all the muscle, you know, the tissue, muscle tissue, the eyes, of course, the brain as well. And while I'm trying to become a psychology major, biology isn't my strength, so you'll have to forgive my complete lack of knowledge of all the different, the parietal lobe, the frontal lobe. I know some basics, but you can see the jaw, a lot of the obvious, some of the muscle tissues, where's the eyes in here? Let me show you. You can just open this model, and you can see a lateral view here. Of course, you can see the spinal cord, the vertebrae, the tongue, the teeth. Of course, here's the tongue here. Again, and just an inside look. Nothing too much to show you there. Of course, here is the human brain. Of course, here is lateral view of the brain. It's the stem, cerebral cortex. So, pretty much this, we believe this is where the response that mental response, sensory response, is. Did I say that earlier? Arkham Sanitarium, mental response, sensory response. I forget how I said that abbreviation, but let me just put this back here. The science of the human mind, the physical brain itself, as well as the chemical makeup, all the neurons and how the human brain works in regards to, you know, depression and different mental states is very difficult to really narrow down and understand and classify. But we are trying our best, so. Just set this over here, if you pardon me. Okay. So I just want to also take your photo, if you don't mind. Oh, and if you don't mind, I show you a photo of my wife as well, my dear Margaret. This is her. Oh, thank you. Yes, she's. Something else, that's for sure. She can be a handful at times. Okay. Let me see here. Get this thing. I'm no photographer, but we do this for record keeping purposes, so we can put a face to the test. This old. Really need a new camera, but funds are so low in this department. Okay. All right, then we have this here. Okay, let me just change. I think we're already set up. There we go. All right. And all I need you to do, please, is to look straight into here. Okay, all right. You and I just want to take one shot from the side just to get a nice profile. Okay, go. Thank you very much. Okay. Do you happen to be in photography at all yourself? It's quite a wonderful hobby, I've heard. Not my particular passion. My particular passion is the workings of the human mind. I'm quite fascinated. If you'll excuse me, this is. There we go. I am quite fascinated by the human mind and its workings. It's so mysterious. Okay, so I'm going to first start, let me perform a little brief health exam. I just want to listen to your heart and your lungs. Here. Just listen to your heart for a moment. It's beating quite strong. Okay. Now I want to listen to your lungs. If you could please breathe in deep and exhale. Again, breathe in and exhale. Okay. Over on this side, breathe in, exhale. And one more time, breathe in and exhale. Okay. All right, I'm not really too interested, or it's not really necessary to perform, a blood pressure check. I just want to get a general assessment of your health. Okay, and let me see your wrist here. I do just want to check your pulse. Okay. Thank you. Now I just want to check your eyes. If you don't mind, you could just look straight here at my nose. Okay, just again right here, just checking your pupils. Make sure they respond. Okay, all right, wonderful. I'm just gonna do a little light follow. So if you could just please stare at the light, okay? Follow the light, actually. Okay, great. You seem fine. Okay, just wants you to hold up your fists. Okay, and then just squeeze your fists real hard. Okay, I'm going to squeeze your fists myself. Try to push as hard as you can against my hands. Okay, here we go. Again. All right. All right, now just the left. Just try to push as hard as you can. Great. And then your right. Very good. Let me just check your shoulders here. Bridge your shoulders up like this, please. Wonderful. Let them sag. Very good. Okay. All right. So, no problems with any of your arms or your muscles, any fatigue or anything like that? Okay, good. All right. Let me just make a quick note of that. Forgot to ask that earlier. To make sure you're not experiencing any atrophy or any kind of problems with your muscles, anything like that. I could probably check your reflexes, but it's not too important. Okay, we are going to begin. I'm going to start with some calming hand motions, just like this, and you can just watch my hands. Just move my clipboard out of the way here. There we go. A little bit more room. Okay. And at any time during this test, if you begin to feel that tingling sensation, just tell me and I will make a note as to which part of the test you responded well to. And I'm just going to reach out to you. You've already felt the tingling sensation? Okay. At what point? Oh, in the very beginning. Okay, interesting. So I didn't even need to... really begin this part of the test. That's quite an interesting little fact there. I'll have to make a note of that in just a moment. Can you tell me how this makes you feel? Okay, interesting. Good. I'm just gonna pretend I'm pushing some buttons right here. Just let me know if at any point here you start to feel that response. Pull a lever, turn a dial. It's almost like I'm working at an operator switchboard. Okay, I'm just gonna and I'm pulling a thread here, maybe sewing. Just let me know. You can just watch and enjoy if you begin to feel that familiar sensation. Even though this is a test, you don't have to feel as though you need to force yourself to respond. You can just enjoy what's happening here. Yeah, I'm just gonna see if you respond to these movements. Can you tell me how that made you feel? Okay. Great. So you experienced that pleasant tingling, for lack of a better term, sensation, that ASMR sensation, as I would like to say. Early on, even before we got to this part of the test. Okay. We've heard that before. We're trying to, of course, recreate the certain, well, I should say I'm trying to recreate. I've been charged with this task, but I've kind of taken upon myself part of my graduate courses. But so, you know, we're trying to recreate the same environment as some of the patients that have over at the sanitarium that have reported to us, to the staff. Okay, I have this cutting mat of mine. It's quite one of my favorite things. I use it quite often for cutting paper. Some hobbies of mine: modeling, origami, and such. So I use this quite often. So I'm just going to tap on this, as hopefully you can hear, and just relax and enjoy. In the moment here, I'll see if this helps to trigger a response. Just move from some fast tapping to some slower. Okay, that's gonna do it for my cutting mat. Can you tell me how that made you feel? Okay. Let me just... flip over a new page here. So that was a very pleasant feeling and sensation, or sound, for you? Okay. Great. Right. I'm just going to continue on. Okay, for the next test, I have this roll of tin foil. And as you can hear, it makes a very distinct crinkling sound, for lack of a better word. My wife loves this sound. Oh, yes, you did hear me say she's expecting. Yeah. I haven't really told too many folks, but no, it's not always good luck, but I'll be graduating, and she'll be completing her course as well, and you know, I'll be working towards becoming a professor, I hope, here at Miskatonic University, and hopefully she'll be working as a nurse and will be able to work by my side. But we have been married now, and she is expecting our first child. Thing is, though, what makes matters, and I don't really mean to bore you. Oh, you don't mind? Okay. What makes matters a little more complicated is that once I graduate and obtain my degree, she and I and some of the other faculty members, we are planning on an expedition, either to the deserts of Australia or to the high mountains of the Himalayas. There are some old ruins and such that we are interested in. Some of our colleagues, more for the university, to try to acquire any interesting finds, and I am a little bit of a treasure hunter myself, so I'll be bringing my cutting mat with me, and the camera, and my wife Margaret will probably be about in her, I would say, seven months pregnant at that time. So hopefully we can, you know, embark on the expedition and then return safely home. And everything like that will, everything will go well. So. Find that this is a this is eliciting a that response, that tingling sensation. Believe it or not, and I really shouldn't be saying this, but there are a few individuals over at the sanitarium who suffer from some extreme paranoia, and they use tinfoil as a means of protecting themselves from the government. They think the government is out to get them. Even the faculty. And, so it's sad. It's a shame. I don't want to pity them too much. But okay. All right. Allow me a moment to make a note of that. So, you felt that the tin foil elicited a response, and there's okay. All right. Let's just continue on. There's just a few more things that I would like to do as part of this test, and I'll be sending you on your way. Just have this plastic bottle here. I just want to move it across your field of vision. As I tap on it, just to again see if the movement of it in space, so to speak, has any effect. Whether or not you experience that feeling. Okay. And now I'm just going to open this up, open up the bottle cap, and I'm just going to make some sounds with it again, just to see if this triggers the response in you. I filled it up with water so that the bottle cap makes this particular sound that you're hearing. Otherwise, without the water, without that volume, without the air displaced, it would sound very hollow. And again, I'm just going to move this across your field of vision. Just to see if it helps. Could do this test all the time, you say? Well, we wouldn't be able to pay you each time, but you're more than welcome to come back and take the test as often as you like. At least until I graduate and go on the expedition. going to lightly open and close bottle cap just to generate a different sound to see if there's a certain sound that might actually trigger the response. It's interesting because some of the sanitarium patients when I was on my internship told me that certain sounds are off-putting to them, even certain voices. Some preferred female nurses over male nurses or staff members. Some just liked watching the doctors or the staff members update their records. A lot of them responded to getting their haircuts, though, that's for sure. And getting bathed as well, since, as I said, some weren't able to bathe themselves. Okay. So, let me make a note of that. Did you find yourself responding to the bottle cap in any particular part of that? Was it the movement from side to side across your field of view? Was it the sound of the bottle cap moving across? Okay. And the twisting of the cap off and on. Okay. Okay, just a few more. And we'll have you on your way. Do appreciate your time and your patience. I have some cardboard. This is just a random piece. I'm just going to tap on it like this. It almost has the same sound as the cutting mat, but not quite. A little different. Such a wonderful invention, cardboard, or corrugated cardboard, I should say. There's one particular gentleman over at the sanitarium who has quite a fixation on cardboard. He has cardboard taped to his the walls of his room. He has a hat. Quite a friendly fellow, though. Of course, I'm not allowed to disclose any of the patient's names, but in any case, if I just trace my finger slowly on the cardboard, does that seem to elicit a response? As I said, just trying all these different scenarios to determine if there's any particular rhyme or reason as to why one thing stimulus may work compared to another. It could be a particular sound in conjunction with a certain movement, or in conjunction with someone's voice, or just watching certain movements without any sound involved. It's quite interesting how the human brain works. Scrape. The gentleman that I was talking about just a moment earlier about his obsession with cardboard, he finds this when what he is suffering with becomes too much, he doesn't require any medication. The nursing staff will just go in and do this and calms him right down. It is like an antidote. Strange. An antidote to anxiety. I don't know how else you could put it. Okay. I'm just going to, again, write down. I should probably just keep the clipboard here in my lap. Okay, the cardboard test. Can you tell me how that made you feel? Okay. Feel yourself responding more to the scratching, to the tapping, to the brushing with my finger. Okay. All right. Would you care for a drink of water? Sure, it's freshly filled, so I always offer volunteers for this test a drink. Here you go. Okay, all done. Let's move on. To another nice new invention. Bubble wrap. A lot of the patients and some of the test subjects, such as yourself, seem to respond well to this particular sound, this scrunching, crinkling sound. Of course, it is very difficult to resist the temptation or urge to pop each individual bubble. It's interesting because some of the patients at the sanitarium that enjoy the crinkling of the tinfoil, the sound of the bubble wrap makes them quite agitated. We've witnessed fights between the folks who enjoy the sounds of the tinfoil and those who enjoy the sounds of the bubble wrap. I don't mean to laugh and make light of the situation, but it's a serious concern. You could say it's almost like a battle, if you will, between those few who like tinfoil and those few who like bubble wrap. I think there's even that gentleman that likes the cardboard who's fighting in the as well. So. Okay. Didn't I say I was going to keep this clipboard on my lap? Okay, so can you tell me how the bubble wrap made you feel? Session. I do have leather gloves. I have a pestle and mortar. Spend too much time on these, unfortunately. That reminds me, I just thought about my camera. I'm going to need to take that to the repairman here in Arkham. See if he can fix it. I also have this refuse bag. Makes some really nice more soft crinkling sounds. But I'm not really gonna have time for that either. So we're just gonna finish up with one of my health knowledge books. You can probably see the other one behind me. And I'm just gonna turn the pages here. And then we'll just end the test session here, okay? So, I just want to take this time to thank you very much. You will be compensated, of course, as the advertisement said in the newspaper. Fail, I'm just going to finish this test here. And if you happen to fall asleep, don't worry, I will we'll wake you and we'll send you on your way, okay? So I'm just going to look through here and perhaps read a little bit. And then, like I said, you can just feel free to stay seated and drift off to sleep, or just continue to relax, okay? All right. By the way, these are actually my brother's medical books. Of course, studying psychology, I don't have much of a use for them. I just needed some good bookends. My brother, he's studying pharmaceuticals. He's interested in the treatment of people through medicine, experimental techniques as well. Unfortunately, he was part of a tragic accident during a trip overseas. His face has since become disfigured. But anyway, I don't mean to bore you. Let's just get back to some more page turning here. I hope you enjoy, and thanks again for your cooperation, your patience. And if you do get a chance to explore Arkham, don't forget the theater. Tomorrow night, my dear wife Margaret will be performing at the play. It's quite a heavy volume. Rheumatoid arthritis, muscular rheumatism, gout, catalepsy, tetanus, apoplexy. Disseminated sclerosis, hysteria, delirium, home remedies, colic, earache, fever sores, freckles, pimples.